U.S. baseball team going to Cuba, baseball mecca, at this historic moment in the relations between two traditionally hostile countries, that is a really big deal. Experience was through baseball and because of baseball, the true integration of athletics and academics, college sports. And I'm here to tell you, these are really good people, and this is a really good program. Finally, the most important, the team. What an impressive group of young men and student athletes. It was a real joy to get to know them. I mean, they showed tremendous poise on the field, but particularly off the field, in a very strange location.
Freshman number 9, Austin Riggins. Freshman number 31, Justin Hagenman.
Another reason why we're here. Again, I told you earlier, the speech that he gave our guys and the talk that he gave our guys, you know, when I heard that Rick was going to be our speaker, I was really excited because, number one, he's an unbelievable baseball man. The guy's done just about everything in the game. He's played. He's been a director of player development. He's been in the minor leagues. He's coached, obviously, at the big league level. He's also coached in college. He understands how important college baseball is and what an avenue it is for people.
A lot of pressure on players to win and play well. And I especially see it at the major league level. I live with a bunch of young guys who are no different than this room. And the message I gave to Coach Cooper's team earlier today, from my heart, from my baseball experience, is no different. The exact same chat I'll have with Andrew McCutchen February 18th and Starling Marte and Gregory Polanco and Jordy Mercer. This game is difficult. This game is a simple process that we make complex. Expectations are the death of us. And trying to fight for the truth, what actually is happening around us, and to share exactly what's happening to us and have trust with people around you is the key to success. The pain of discipline versus the pain of regret. I think when you look back at your life as young players, as families, as teammates, as coaches, I think there's a defining moment on who you're going to be and where your integrity is going to come from. You're going to have to pay a price to be what you want to be or who you think you are. If you want to get to the mountaintop and everybody's winning goal is different, but if you're trying to be a factor in the Big Ten and win baseball games, there's going to be that moment whether you care more about others than yourself. It's inevitable to be a champion. That's just my perspective from what I've seen. I have been blessed to be here to share with this young bunch that you're going to make choices and decisions in front of you, not only the baseball ones, but the academic ones. And I want to encourage you not only to compete on that field fiercely, but also in that classroom. Because in reality, let's be honest, and I mentioned this earlier, I think it's 0.10%. The number could be different now, Coach Cooper, I'm not sure. But the statistics say you're not going to play in the big leagues. The statistics say you're not going to get a shot at pro baseball. What are you going to do from there? That academic piece, I've got a degree from the history, from the University of South Carolina, history and political science. And without it, there are things in my life I wouldn't have been able to do. I think that at some point there's going to be a game plan. I think you look and you fight like heck for plan A, and I love it. Somebody's going to play center field for the Pirates after Andrew's done. Somebody, and why not a Nittany line? I'm in. Okay, but now when A doesn't happen, are you ready for plan B? I'm on plan Q, by the way. This club's got a chance to do something special. You've got a great coaching staff. You've got tremendous support. You've got all the facilities. You've got all the opportunities to be the best you can be. The question is, will you, as an individual, take advantage of it? Pain of discipline versus the pain of regret. I hope I didn't get too deep and too serious there. I got my chance and I took advantage of it. I wish you the very best. Thank you for your time.